Hello everyone. Let's see how to use an archive database. To create and configure an HMI input variable for archiving, go in your CAT HMI interface and click on this symbol in the attribute column. Select the Trending and Archive attribute. In the Value column, click here to configure variable sampling limits. Enter the maximum number of values to be archived. This is actually the circular buffer size. Enter the minimum wait time for the next value to be archived, and the minimum difference between the previously archived value. Don't forget to select the Archive checkbox to make archiving possible, and the Use Archiving checkbox to indicate that this variable must be archived. Right-click on your CAT. Select Attribute and go to Exported tab. Each instance of the CAT can have different archive parameters. You can create a specific history trend configuration. Right-click on your solution name and select Configurations, History Trend. The History Trend Configuration Manager opens. Right-click on Configurations and create a new one. In the Series field, click the icon to open the Trend Series Collection Editor. Click on Add and select the path to the HMI input variable values you want to view. You can also change the value scales and the time interval. Then click OK. Open a canvas and add a history trend. And test the HMI with two buttons. In the Running Canvas toolbar, click the configuration icon to open the History Trend Configuration Manager. Select a configuration and click OK to apply it. Here is a little tip. You can open automatically your configuration. In the History Trend properties, go in the miscellaneous configuration name and enter the name of your History Trend configuration. You can also change here the update interval to 1 second, for example. Then test your HMI. That's it. Now you know how to use an archive database.